welcome to Radiant Kids TV this week. I am so glad that you're with me. We are going to hear about Peter and a man named Cornelius. So stay tuned. Here we go.
Hi, Radiant Kids. Stand up on your feet. It's time to sing.
King.
If you were at Renew this past week, you would have heard me read a book called The Friend Who Forgives. If you weren't there, I highly recommend going on YouTube and you can hear the author read this book. It gives us a bit of a background story for a man named Peter, who we are going to hear about in today's story. Now, first of all, I want all of you to stand up on your feet. I'll give you a minute to do that. Go ahead, stand up, everybody. Now, if you are currently living in the city that you were born, I want you to sit down. Now, if you are between the ages of 3 and 5, I want you to sit down. If you have purple hair, sit down. Did anyone sit down on that one? I'm wondering if anyone did. Okay, I've got a couple more, so if you're still standing, don't worry. Now, if you have a pet in your house, I want you to sit down. And if you have a favorite food, I want you to sit down. Okay, anyone still standing, you can go ahead and sit down. Now that was kind of a funny game, wasn't it? I kind of picked out certain things and was like, if you do this, then you can sit down. But the good news is that that's not how the gospel works. Did you know that? God doesn't look for certain traits in people and is like, oh, I think they're really good. I'll choose them to be one of my children. That is not at all how it works. There aren't certain traits that earn you God's love. The gospel is for everyone. I want you to consider this big picture question and answer. We've got a new one this week. It is, what is the gospel? The gospel is the good news that God sent his son Jesus into the world to rescue sinners. The whole Bible tells the story of God's rescue plan, and the church is made up of all the people who heard the good news, believe it is true, and trust in Jesus to save them. By the power of the Holy Spirit, the church works together as one body to love people and guide people to trust and obey Jesus. Now we're going to take a quick look back. After Jesus rose from the grave and returned to heaven, he sent the Holy Spirit at Pentecost to live in his disciples and give them power. Last Sunday was actually Pentecost Sunday. That's when the church all around the world celebrates that first coming of the Holy Spirit. By his power, the disciples preached the truth, taught the good news, and performed miracles. Many people came to faith in Jesus. The church grew and began to spread, but for the most part, it was Jewish people who believed and became part of the church. Peter was one of the Jewish disciples who traveled and shared the message of Jesus. This is the same Peter that we read about in the Gospels. In our Bible story today, we will see how God used a vision to show Peter that the good news of Jesus is not just for the Jews, but the gospel is for all people from every nation, tribe, and people group. Here is Peter and Cornelius.
Cornelius was an officer in the Roman army who lived in Caesarea. He and everyone in his house worshiped God. Cornelius helped other people and he always prayed to God. One afternoon, Cornelius saw an angel of God in a vision which frightened him. The angel said to him, "God has heard your prayers and he has seen how you help others." Then the angel told Cornelius to send for a man named Peter, who was in the city of Joppa. So Cornelius sent two of his servants and one soldier to Joppa. The next day, as the servants and the soldier were nearing the city, Peter went up on the roof of the house to pray. Peter saw a vision of something like a large sheet coming down from heaven. In the sheet were all kinds of animals, reptiles, and birds. A voice said to him, "Get up, Peter, kill and eat." "No, Lord," Peter said. "I have never eaten anything that is unclean or not used for food." Again, a voice said to him, "God has made these clean. Do not call them unclean." This happened 3 times, and then the whole thing was taken up into heaven. Peter tried to understand what the vision meant. Then Cornelius' men arrived at the gate. They explained that Cornelius had seen a vision, and an angel instructed him to send for Peter. So the next day, Peter went with the men to Caesarea. When Peter got to Cornelius' house, he explained to Cornelius that God does not consider some people to be better than others. God had sent good news to the Israelites. Jesus is the Lord of all. Peter said, "Everyone who believes in Jesus will have their sins forgiven." As Peter said this, the Holy Spirit came down on those who heard the message, not just the Jews, but the Gentiles or non-Jews too. The Jewish believers were amazed. Cornelius, his friends, and his relatives were baptized in the name of Jesus, and Peter stayed with them for a few days. God showed Peter that just as there is no clean or unclean food in Christ, there are no clean and unclean people. God calls believers to tell everyone the good news about Jesus, no matter who they are or where they come from. Jesus is the Lord of all.
Cornelius was an officer in the Roman army. The Roman army was known for treating the local people, especially the Jews, very poorly. Cornelius, however, was different. He was a believer in the one true God and was known for how kindly he treated the Jews. Cornelius believed in God, but he did not follow the customs and traditions of the Jewish people, including following their beliefs about eating clean and unclean foods. These were the strict Old Testament laws about which animals could and could not be eaten. Normally, a Jewish man like Peter would never be seen with a man like Cornelius because he was a foreigner. But the vision God gave Peter was about more than food. God brought Peter and Cornelius together to encourage Cornelius to believe the gospel and to teach Peter that the gospel is for all people. God's plan all along has been to glorify his name in the entire earth. The blessings that God promised to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob way back in the Old Testament were always supposed to be carried through them to the rest of the world, a blessing used to bless others. Jesus, the fulfillment of that promised blessing, had come, lived a perfect life, died the death we deserve, and rose again to defeat death. The time had come for Peter and the other apostles to carry the gospel beyond just the Jewish people to people of all nations. As Peter preached to the Gentile people who had gathered with Cornelius, the Holy Spirit came down, not only on the Jewish people, but also on the Gentiles. This amazed all the Jewish believers and confirmed the message of Peter's vision that the gospel is for everyone. God doesn't show favoritism or reject or restrict anyone because of a person's ethnicity or nationality. Now let's look back at our big picture question. What is the gospel? The gospel is the good news that God sent his son Jesus into the world to rescue sinners. The Bible teaches that all people are born in sin, and so we all need a savior. That is why the gospel is so beautiful. Now let's watch questions from kids.
Hey there, I'm Pastor Brian, and it's time for questions from kids. Lydia from Greenbrier, Arkansas asks,
I get along with some people better than others. How am I supposed to not show favoritism?
Lydia, that is a great question. And I think the first thing we have to understand is this. It's okay to get along with some people more than other people. It's okay to have some friends that you're closer with and spend more time with. That is totally normal. If you look in the Bible, Jesus even did that. He spent more time with his 12 disciples. He spent more time with 3 of those disciples in particular, and he had some other really close friends. So there's nothing at all wrong with that. Here's what we have to be careful of. It's not showing favoritism toward people. What is favoritism? It's treating people differently. So if you treat people poorly because they're not some of your closest friends, then that would be wrong. That's what we see in our Bible story today, that God does not show favoritism. He treats everybody the same. He loves everybody. And that's what we want to do as well. We want to be at a point where we have some closer friends, nothing wrong with that again, but we love everybody. We're kind to everybody. We want everybody to know Jesus, and we respect everybody. That's how we can not show favoritism to people around us. So here's a question back for you. How do you feel knowing that God does not show favoritism?
I have a new Bible verse for you, and it is a great one. It is 1 Chronicles 16, verse 31, and it says, "Let the heavens be glad, and let the earth rejoice, and let them say among the nations, the Lord reigns." The Lord reigns. This should make your heart glad. God is the one true God, is in control of everything, and rules over all people. The gospel is for all people, and salvation is the free gift of God to all who believe in him. He is Lord of all creation, which means he is God over all nations. The Bible says that one day, people from every tongue, that's like every language, every tribe, and every nation will proclaim together that the Lord reigns as they worship at the throne of God. His plan to rescue the world from sin is reason to praise him. Would you pray with me? Lord, before even time began, you knew that we would need a Savior. Thank you for sending Jesus to be our rescuer and the perfect sacrifice for our sins. Thank you that salvation is not a result of our works, but is only because of what Jesus has done. We praise you for the gift of salvation you offer to all who believe. Help us to honor you and give you the glory you deserve. All people are made in your image, and we pray for your love to fill us and help us love everyone around us. Give us courage to tell the world of your love and mercy. Thank you that you are Lord of all. In Jesus' name, amen.
everyone. Welcome back to another Experiments with a Purpose. Now, the next 2 weeks, we are going to be talking about bubbles. All right. I know all of you love bubbles. It's one of my favorite things. But usually when you touch bubbles with your finger, you pop it, right? Or you burst it. Well, in today's experiment, I'm going to show you how to actually put your finger through a bubble without bursting it. All right. Now, speaking of bursting, I had to find a passage in the Bible about the word burst. And here it is. It's in Psalm chapter 28, verse 7. And it says, "The Lord is my strength and shield. I trust him with all my heart. He helps me, and my heart is filled with joy. I burst out in songs of thanksgiving." So because God is our strength and shield, we don't have to be afraid. So we can be filled with joy and be so full of thanksgiving that we're like a bubble and we feel like bursting, right? Now, for today's experiment, you're going to need a coat hanger. And this is a coat hanger that I pulled into a like kind of a square. And then I took some pipe cleaner and I put it around the edge just so that it forms the bubble better. And you're gonna need a little loop of thread that your parents can tie into a loop for you. And the last thing that you're going to need is bubble solution. Now, for today's bubble solution, what you want to do is you want to take 2 tablespoons of sugar, mix it with 1.5 cups of warm water, and then you just mix it till the sugar goes away. And then to that, you're going to want to add 1/2 cup of dishwasher soap to it, all right? And then just mix it all up, and then what you'll have is a nice thick solution to make our bubble with today, all right? So I'll see you back in the indoor laboratory. Hi everyone, welcome back to our indoor laboratory. Now, I have a mask on because the soap bubble is really delicate and sometimes when I talk while I'm doing this experiment, it pops it. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna put my mask on, all right? And in front of me is our water, our soap bubble solution and our coat hanger. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just basically carefully pull up a layer of soap bubble film, and then I'm gonna take a circular piece of string or thread, and I'm just going to lay it on top, right? All right. So this. Lay it on top, like that, okay? Then what you wanna do is you wanna just take a pencil and just pop the inside. And just like that, you have a hole in your bubble that you can stick your finger through. And I hope you enjoyed this week's Experiment with a Purpose, and I'll see you next week. Bye-bye.
We are back on the birthday train. This week, we say a super happy birthday to Noah Chang. Happy birthday, Noah. And also to Isabel Marsh. Happy birthday, Isabel. I hope that both of you have a fantastic time celebrating. As we approach summer, I would like you to keep something in mind. We would love to have a little bit of help around here over the summer months with both doing our songs, maybe even experiments with a purpose. So if you or your family is interested in helping us with those things, you can send me an email to kids, now this part has changed, so pay attention, kids@mvachurch.org, and I can have a chat with your parents and figure something out to have you involved. Thank you so much for watching this week. I hope you have a fantastic week ahead, and we will see you next time on Radiant Kids TV. Bye-bye.